might meet you all. And welcome to St. James's Church in Killorglin for the Requiem Mass for Father Fleming, Canon Fleming, parish priest here for almost 17 years. I welcome also all who are joining us through the parish radio and through the live streaming. We gather as a community of faith. We gather to support Father Michael's family. And on behalf of all, I offer our sympathy and support of our prayers to his sister, May, and Eileen, and his brother, Patrick, in New Jersey, his sister, Delord, and sister, Angela, his sister-in-law, brother-in-law, nieces and nephews, grandnieces and grandnephews, great-grandnephews, and great-grandnieces, Bishop Ray, and the priest in the diocese, his parishioners here in Killorglin and all the communities he served, his secretary Marion and his staff here in Killorglin, and all his relatives and kind neighbours and many friends. We join in prayer together for the happy repose of his soul. And we begin our Mass in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. As we begin, we pause for a moment to remind ourselves that we have here no lasting city. As Bishop Ray said in his introductory remarks, we never know the day or the hour. We humbly bow down as sinners in God's presence, acknowledging our unworthiness and pleading for mercy for Father Michael, for any sin especially which he may not have made restitution. So take a moment of quiet to reflect and recollect ourselves as we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries.
With power, and because God was with him, Jesus went about doing good and curing all who had fallen into the power of the devil. Now I and those with me have witnessed to everything he did throughout the countryside of Judea and in Jerusalem itself, and also to the fact that they killed him by hanging him on a tree. Yet 3 days afterwards, God raised him to life and allowed him to be seen, not by the whole people, but only by certain witnesses God had chosen beforehand. Now we are those witnesses. We have eaten and drunk with him after his resurrection from the dead, and he has ordered us to proclaim this to his people and to tell them that God has appointed him to judge everyone, alive or dead. It is to him that all the prophets bear this witness, that all who believe in Jesus will have their sins forgiven through his name. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Remember the good news that I carry, Jesus Christ risen from the dead, sprung from the race of David. It is on account of this that I have my own hardships to bear, even to be chained like a criminal, but they cannot chain up God's news. So I bear it all for the sake of those who are chosen, so that in the end they may have the salvation that is in Christ Jesus and the eternal glory that comes with it. Here is a saying that you can rely on. If we have died with him, then we shall live with him. If we hold firm, then we shall reign with him. If we disown him, then he will disown us. We may be unfaithful, but he is always faithful, for he cannot disown his own self. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus replied, I tell you most solemnly, if you do not eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you will not have life in you. Anyone who does eat my flesh and drink my blood has eternal life, and I shall raise him up on the last day. For my flesh is real food, my blood is real drink. He who eats my flesh and drinks my blood lives in me, and I live in him. As I, who am sent by the living Father, myself draw life from the Father, so whoever eats me will draw life from me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, not like the bread our ancestors ate, they are dead. But anyone who eats this bread will live forever. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Can I welcome each of you here to St. James's Church in Killorglin for the Requiem Mass for Canonmichael Fleming, better known to many as Father Michael. Whether you're here in the church or excluded due to the restrictions imposed by the COVID-19 pandemic, we are all linked through the parish radio and through the St. James's live streaming on its inaugural voyage. How ironic. And we are together as a community of faith, comprising Father Michael's family, his parishioners, friends, neighbours and Scartaglen, Bishop Ray, Bishop Bill, clergy and religious of the diocese and beyond, and especially his taxmates in Kerry and elsewhere. We are all united in praying for the happy repose of his soul, and we have condolences taskmates, Father Archbishop Michael Nearly of Cume, and Bishop Brendan Kelly of Galway, and also Father Michael O'Donoghue in Newark in the USA. News of Father Michael's death last Friday morning came as a huge shock to all associated with him. But his unexpected death came as devastation and desolation to his family. This was partly due, I believe, because in the hours and days immediately following his surgery in the CUHDAB, the reports and updates were promising and encouraging. Naturally, when news is positive, our expectations are that all will be well. But the devastation for Father Michael's family and its various generations is due also to the fact that you mattered an awful lot to him and he to you in whatever side of the Atlantic you call home. Whatever magnetism there was to his personality, both with his family and many other people, clergy and daily life, it was most definitely not forged on his part through showmanship or by populism. My mind, if remote, would capture the person that was the youngest child born to Patrick Jane or Fleming, and given the name Michael Benedict at his baptism, I think it is the word authentic. His bond with all to whom he was dear was due to the fact that he was authentic. Like it or lump it, what you saw was what you got, warts and all. Father Mikey, as he was known to a few, didn't do clawmouths or wrong creed. He was a committed and dedicated and energetic priest of our diocese for almost 49 years, and practically 17 of those years spent here in Toronto. I have no doubt that he worked hard in each of his assignments. In fact, he was a Trojan warrior, one who didn't know the end of his strength. In fact, because he was blessed with great stamina, maybe he didn't always appreciate that some of us tire more quickly than he did. But more recently, even with him, energy had begun to wane, bones had begun to ache, and breathlessness had become more of an issue. The personnel situation in the diocese meant that he had to be on his own in this large parish, where not so long ago there had been three priests. And he was VF in the pastoral area of Killorglin with three priests and two deacons in parish ministry, where once there had been 10 priests and several religious sisters. The truth is that an ever-increasing workload means that one's receptivity or patience may from time to time be in short supply, as we each have our wants. Furthermore, expectations as to how priests and people ought to collaborate are such nowadays that even greater demands than ever are inevitably imposing themselves on the priest's ground. And this is unfolding at a time when the age profile of the clergy is rising sharply. Both as a person and as a priest, Father Fleming took getting to know and getting used to. He was big in stature, with an exterior of steel which guarded a big heart, a warm and generous heart. A man of great wit, with a droll sense of humour. A colleague of his recalled an occasion when they were travelling from Tralee to the other Desmond Hotel for an important event. And somewhere close to many city ones, they encountered two donkeys wandering towards them along the road. He equipped his chauffeur, two donkeys coming into town, and two more donkeys going out. And there was plenty of scuffing in too. One such incident happened on the morning of a funeral in Fleset. A credible rumour was circulated that the Cardinal Tomaso Fee was coming from Armagh by helicopter for the funeral at noon. A phone call was made, instructions were issued, and about 11:30 two gentlemen dispatched themselves to the nearby football field to put in place and to keep in place a white sheet on the ground in accordance with the pipes of structure supposedly, to hit guide pipes, to hit the pipe of guide the helicopter. In the meantime, within sight of the crowd gathered nearby for the funeral, the obvious question for anybody who noticed the boys on was, what are the two boys up to with the white sheet? As the time drew close to the entrance bell at noon, there was neither sight nor sound of the helicopter, and it began to dawn on the two that the entire episode was a well-staged prank. It was firmly believed that the priest was scalped at his fingers in that pipe, but of course, nowhere had his fingerprints to be found. He was rooted in Scartaglen and its environs, and he was simply in his interests. For as long as he was able to enjoy the game of golf with the seniors and dukes, or a few days golfing away with his colleagues, which you could only beg for the Lord's protection if you had the misfortune of walking across his line on the green, or talking as he was to take a swing, or lying on the court. He also liked to read the game of cards across the winter. And in addition to the simplicity of his interests, his tastes were equally simple. He never made too many demands of the water by the fertility of golfing attire. So long as his clothes were clean, he didn't worry about their age, or their shape, or their eyebrow. But all of this masked a great range. His interventions at meetings tended to be few, but a brief sentence from him could either capture the essence of the entire proceedings, or it could expose the gaping flaw that had gone unnoticed to many others in attendance. During his 15 and a half years in various assignments in Killorglin from 1986 to 2001, those years afforded a listening ear and provided wise counsel when required to Bishop Dearman and Bishop Bill. But the reason for our being here today is because he was a priest. His priesthood was centered on the Eucharist, the living bread come down from heaven. Yes, of course, he enjoyed community involvements, especially those with the GAA, be it as a 5-year-old mascot, a player, a committee member, and particularly in most recent times as a supporter. But first and last, he was a priest of God's church. He was a loyal and dependable priest. The seal of confession was very safe in his care. He was very clear that we who are ordained sinners, striving after holiness, have nothing to offer the faith communities of which we are part, unless we are centered on Jesus Christ, present in the Eucharist. Without a deep commitment to the presence of Christ in the Eucharist, and without care for and reverence in its celebration, we are nothings. Sweet nothings. Yes, he would seem unconcerned about him, unperturbed by matters he had perceived and had been dripped up by a mad monk who was able to sleep some night. But it was the Mass that mattered. As priests, we have nothing to offer people unless our own foundations are sure. Because Father Michael knew that what was trite and what was superficial neither endures, nor sustains, nor consoles, nor offers hope. For many years it had been our custom, if at all possible, to make it to Cork Park when Kerry were involved in the All Ireland semi-final and final. The day or two beforehand, this snappy text would come something along the lines of, staying in Kilcock with PJ for the weekend, meet in Glen Ford for breakfast on Saturday morning at 10:30. For Vio will drive, I'm taking the front seat, and don't you dare put your knees into my bed. And P.S., you're saying the 9 o'clock mass at Kilcock on Sunday morning. The PJ in question was a classmate from his Maynooth days who died suddenly in 2016. Pat Devere is a long-time friend of Father Michael's in New Pleasant, and was Pat who drove him to the COH last Sunday week. His chair is now vacant, his voice is silent, his heart is still. But as we bid him farewell, we cherish the memories, the conversations, the fun, and the arguments. Above all, we must not abandon or forget the purpose of his life, his ministry, and indeed the ministry of all priests. But it lets us endeavour to keep that ministry alive and vibrant. In many respects, the extent to which we do so will be the true measure and the true depth both of our friendship and our faith. A vigilander, Thosul Mamma Tishiklu and Yukthana Mam, Agashem Bogus, Gimimina, Agaskapin, and Abadishandu, Rainikator each in the lawn of Bogus. Slan Ale, Agasun Shiri, he called the name.
God our Father brought his Son through the darkness of Calvary to the glory of the resurrection. We are confident that he will bring us also through the darkness of death to his kingdom of light and peace. For Father Michael, who has passed from this life, may he now reach the joy and peace of life eternal. Lord, hear us. For his family, friends, colleagues, and parishioners who are shocked and saddened by his unexpected death, that in this time of sorrow and sadness, the risen Lord may be their strength and consolation. Lord, hear us. For all who have supported Father Michael in his ministry as a priest, that the Lord may reward them for the care and their kindness. Lord, hear us. For the sick, both at home and in hospital, we pray for their families and for all who care for the sick. Lord, hear us. We pray for all those whose lives and livelihoods have been affected by the coronavirus. We remember those who have died, those who suffered, those who mourn, and those who help. Lord, hear us. For grieving families at this time, that despite the current restrictions for funerals, they may feel the support, solidarity, and care of the community. Lord, hear us. We pray for the deceased members of Michael's family and extended family. Remember his parents, Patrick J. and Laura Fleming, his brother-in-law, Billy Will Fleming, and all deceased family members. We pray that eternal life will be theirs. Lord, hear us. Today we pray for vocations. Lord, hear us. For our own personal prayers and intentions, we pray in silence. Lord, hear us. Lord, may you support us all the day long, till the shadows lengthen and the evening falls, and the busy world is hushed and the fever of life is over, and our work is done. Then in your mercy, Lord, grant us a safe lodging, a holy rest, and peace at last. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
We stand and pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be accepted to God, the Almighty Father. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that through these holy mysteries, Father Michael, your servant and priest, may behold mortality forever, but he faithfully minister to him through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices be prayed join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we attain. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink of it, that this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Brendan, St. James, and with all the saints in this constant intercession in your presence, with a life of faith. May this sacrifice of all reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope and our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered through all the world. Remember your servant, Father Michael, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, and from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who are dying, and transform our lowly body after the passion of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like it for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to shift my mind, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. In the body and blood of Christ, keep me safe for eternity.
All praise and all thanks to you.
we stand and pray. Having received the sacrament of salvation, we implore your kindness, O God, for Father Michael, your servant and priest, that as you make him a steward of your mysteries on earth, so you may bring him to be nourished by their truth and reality as unveiled in heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I'd like to thank all of you for your prayerful presence. Thank all who were able to join through the parish radio and the live streaming. As we disperse today in sadness, let us continue to remember one another in prayer, and especially to continue to pray for the happy repose of Father Michael. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And at this time, Father Ray, who now Bishop Ray, will lead us in the prayer of final commendation.
And let's be mindful that we come at Easter time. Let's be mindful of our Easter faith. Christ is risen. Christ is with us. Christ is on the way through our death. He is open for us all. The door to eternal life. So let us be full of faith. Let us be strong and let's be mindful of all who mourn, Father Michael. Maybe especially all from the parish, all for whom he's been their priest for 17 years. We ask his continued blessing on the whole parish community. We come now to the prayers of commendation. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Father Michael. Now we come and ask for a while. For his sadness and parting, we take comfort in the hope that one day we should see him again and enjoy his friendship. We will disperse in sorrow, but the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. Please sprinkle holy water and incense his coffin. May our prayers rise like the incense. May the holy water remind us of baptism, of Christ's life in us. In baptism, we are born for eternal life. Our response: receive his soul and present it to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. May Christ come unto you, take you himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and the perpetual light shine upon him. Lord God, you choose our brother Father Michael to serve your people as a priest and to share the joys and burdens of their lives. Look with mercy on him, give him the reward of his labors, give him the fullness of life promised to those who preach the holy gospel. We pray through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Father Michael, in the angel entry to paradise, may the martyrs come to welcome you. May they take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. In peace, We take our brother to his place of rest.
God of mercy and love, grant to Father Michael, your servant and priest, a warm place at your heavenly table. For you made him here on earth a faithful minister of your word and sacrament. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We join now in praying a decade of the Rosary.